Good morning, students. Yesterday we had a good class. We saw initial examples. I want to take one more example which seems actually important. Example number 5. Look at this question. Says in triangle OPQ, right angle at P and OP is equal to 7 centimeter. Also OQ minus PQ is equal to 1 centimeter. Find the value of sine Q and cos Q. These two questions we are having, this is a question we are having here. Question is easy. Look at first, we'll make the picture. We have a right angle triangle in which angle P is 90 degree. So P is equal to 90 degree we formed here. We are told to find sine Q and cos Q. So intentionally that Q I won't write here, because now Q will work as an acute angle. And P, Q and O will be written here. Even if you make Q here, no matter at all, the front of Q, it is a perpendicular. This time Q is here, so in front of Q, it is a perpendicular. So now we have three sides. OP is equal to 7 and OQ is equal to, OQ minus PQ is equal to 1. Unfortunately, we are just having a single side, which is given side. In last few questions, we saw that we had given a two side and a third side we could find. We can find by the Pythagoras theorem. This time we are just having a single side, so no matter at all, but the equation OP minus PQ is OQ minus PQ is equal to 1 is given. We will take the help of this equation. We want to find sine Q and cos Q, but ultimate condition is only that you need anyhow all three sides. Until you won't have all three sides, you cannot find out sine Q and cos Q under the acute angle Q. So don't worry about first using Pythagoras theorem, which is OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square. OQ is equal to unknown, it is still unknown. OP is equal to 7 sevens are 49, right, directly 7 square plus PQ square. And I don't want to do any work again further this. I just want to put equation 1, because we are helpless here. OQ we don't have, PQ we don't have, we just had a OP which already had put here, and we got a square of 7. 7 sevens are 49. So don't worry about that. What given, write it. We have given OQ minus PQ is equal to 1. It meaning that OQ is equal to 1 plus PQ, meaning I transfer to PQ that side. And we got a conclusion that we can write OQ is equal to 1 plus PQ. And simply I would say that I would join these two. Instead of OQ here, I will write 1 plus PQ. So put this value, in equation number 1, what will get? This was given, I got an equation OQ is equal to 1 plus PQ is a good substitute of OQ. So I'll put here OQ square equal to 1 plus PQ whole square. This is equal to 49 plus PQ square. Now, what to do? Just have to open by all the way A plus B whole square. By using A plus B whole square, it is A square plus B, B meaning PQ square plus 2AB, 2 into 1 into PQ is equal to 49 plus PQ square. That's simple. Now this PQ square and PQ square both cancel, because both have a plus sign and between them it is equal to sign. So only remaining 2PQ plus 1 equal to 49, and one can easily find the rest work. 49 minus 1 is 48. So PQ is equal to 48 upon 2, it's a 24. So you got a value of PQ. Now put a PQ here and get your OQ. So by 2, I have OQ is equal to 1 plus PQ. 1 plus PQ meaning 24. So lastly, I would say that it is 25. So all three sides we already got PQ here and OQ here. So both 24 and 25 respectively got. and already we are having OP. So lastly, we want to find out sine Q and cos Q. It's a formality only. So sine Q is equal to under the Q, sine meaning perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and search out. Front of Q, it's a perpendicular 7, and hypotenuse is OQ, which is already 25. This is answer. And about cos theta is again a formality, it's a base upon hypotenuse. So what is the base for cos theta? Sorry, it's a theta, I have written Q. For cos Q, again front of that it is a 7, perpendicular, and this is a base and this is hypotenuse. So answer is base upon hypotenuse, base is PQ, PQ meaning 24 upon 25. This is answer. This is a very easy question. So hope you have got. See once or twice, you can get it easily. So now we are on exercise. So hope you have some questions of the exercise as I told you yesterday. So easy questions we will leave. Seventh, we want to try seventh one. If cot theta is equal to 7 upon 8, find the first question, 1 plus sine theta into 1 minus sine theta upon 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. This is a simple question. It looks actually heavy, but it is a very simple question. Again, I tell you one thing. Whatever you want to find the value in which sine and cos are including, appearing, and you have a cot theta given. So first, your duty, to with the help of cot theta, find required things, sine and cos. So okay, I tell you that how to start. First of all, you will write given. This is yesterday's task, we did it actually. Cot theta equal to 7 by 8. And what is the meaning of cot? Cot, you know that it is a opposite of tan theta. So what was a tan? It was a perpendicular upon base. This time it is base upon perpendicular. Before it, I want to make the triangle just a side here, and we don't have any triangle name, so we are independent to label our triangle name like ABC, but spatially theta is an acute angle, so label here at a theta, because always I used to take theta here, the front of theta, it is perpendicular, it is a base, it's hypotenuse. Fine. Now, when I wrote here cot meaning base upon perpendicular, you should remember that cot meaning just opposite of a reverse of a tan theta. So tan was a perpendicular upon base, it is a base upon perpendicular. Now you have to go with, again, base is what? BC, and perpendicular was AB, and now go with let BC is equal to 7k. I told you yesterday, whenever the ratio is given, you have to assume the value with some common ratio like 7k, and AB is equal to, go with 8k. So this is 7k, this is 8k. Now I'll find AC. AC, how will find AC? By Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. What is AC square? Is still unknown. What is AB square? It's 8k square, meaning 64k square, and BC square means 7k square, meaning 49k square. So ultimately we are having 113k square. And when I will find AC, definitely 113k square will be there, but k 113 cannot come out because it doesn't have any special pair, but k square can come out as a k. Now we are having AC, BC and AB, all the values in the form of K, no matter at all. Now search out at what you need. You need sine and cos. So I'll first find sine. The sine meaning perpendicular upon hypotenuse. And this time you are having all three sides in the form of K. You are independent to find sine theta. Perpendicular upon hypo. What is perpendicular? 8K. And what is hypotenuse? 113K. So K and K will cancel. Answer is this one. Don't afraid that it is wrong, it is correct, sine theta. Now it's duty to go with cos theta, base upon hypotenuse. So what is a base and hypotenuse? A base is 7k upon 130. But this is gonna be, sorry, k, k and k. Hypotenuse was 113k. So k and k cancel, So what we got? 7 upon 113. So this is cos theta and this is a sine theta. When you have got both, write your question. Then write your question. What is the question? 1 plus sine theta, 1 minus sine theta, 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta. Now it is a simple duty to put all these sine and cos in the place of sine and cos. But before doing or before putting the value, one simple property is looking there, which is a plus b into a minus b. So as far as the easiest concern, I tell you that you should use the property a plus b, a minus b. It is a square minus b square. So using the property a plus b and a minus b, it is a square minus b square, and use it here. It looks a square meaning 1 square minus sine square, downside a plus b, a minus b, a square and b square. So 1 square is itself meaning 1, so I am not writing that square. And you got 1 minus sine square theta upon 1 minus cos square theta. And now put up the value. What is sine square theta? 8 upon 113 whole square upon, downside is 1 minus 7 upon 113 square. Our simple solutions being 1, 8 is a 64 upon 113. Definitely square root of 113 here, it's square root of 113 will be only 113. Downside is 1 minus 7 sevens are 49 upon again 113 will come. Take an LCM. It is 113 minus 64 upon 113 minus 49, because 113 113 will cancel from each other. And the answer is 49 upon 66. This is an answer of the question. This is. So hope I think it is a correct. If calculation is right, answer will be correct. I don't want to check it. If calculation is a mistake, you search out and get your answer. So hope this question is now with you. You can watch many time, as many time you want. And now I'll go on the other question. Look at. We have 8 questions with similar question. So 8 okay, 8 will do it just as a practice. Now I'll leave on the you only hold the exercise. Still 8 question, look at. If 3 cot A is equal to 4, check whether 1 minus 10 square A upon 1 plus 10 square A is equal to cos square a minus sine square a or not. Maybe true or maybe false, you have to check it. So again, an easy question comes. You have to do left hand side and right hand side, and both answers should be same, or should may or may not. How to start the answer? First I will write given. I'll be little fast now. 3 cot a equal to 4. This is given. So cot a is equal to what comes? 4 by 3. 4 by 3. So again, same sentence comes. I just want to make a triangle, because triangle is never not a mention here, but A is an acute angle. So I would take A here, but the rest level I can take from my side. A, B, C, something like that. But A is an acute angle, because A, everywhere A is being there. So I want to take A as an acute angle. Now cot meaning, as I taught you, base upon perpendicular, 4 upon 3. And let I would say base is equal to 4k and perpendicular is equal to 3k. So either you can write base is equal to 3k or something like what is base AB, perpendicular BC, 4 upon 3, and assume that AB equal to 4k and BC equal to 3k. So AB equal to 4k, BC equal to 3k. What about AC? You know, by Pythagoras theorem, what comes? AC square is equal to BC square plus AB square. So what is AC square comes? BC meaning 3K meaning 9K square plus 16K square, 25K square. This is AC square. So what is AC comes? Definitely 5 and K, because 25 have a square root 5 and K square is K. So you got an AC, you have these two. Now what is required in all the way, like tan required, cos required, and sine. So find all. Tan A. What is the meaning of tan A? Tan A. Perpendicular upon base. So what is perpendicular? 3k. What is base? 4k. K and K cancel. 3 by 4. This is tan A. And what you need here? Cos A. Okay. Cos A. Cos meaning base upon hypotenuse. So what is the base? 4k. What is hypotenuse? Is a 5k. So k will cancel. 4 by k. 5, sorry. Cos A. And lastly, sin A. Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. What is the perpendicular? 3k. And what is hypotenuse? AC is equal to 5k. So k and k cancel. Answer 3 by 5. This is not. These are only values. This is not our answer. Now I'll take a left hand side and right hand side. Both. So I'll go a left hand side. It appears 1 minus tan square A upon 1 plus tan square A. And be fast for that because it is easy. 1 minus, do direct, tan square A. What is tan A? 3 by 4. What is tan square A? 9 by 16. What about here? 1 plus 9 by 16. Take an LCM, 16 minus 9. Upon 16 plus 9. Because both 16 will cancel. 7 upon 25. This is LHS. Now what about the RHS? Cos square A minus sin square A. What is cos square A? Cos square meaning 16 by 25. And sin square A meaning 9 by 16. Sorry. Sin A meaning 9 by 25. So your LCM is 25. 16 minus 9 is 7 upon 25. Lastly, we can say that both answers are true. Meaning it was asked that whether these are true. Yes, this is true. The answer is this. So, student, this is good enough for the day. You do try whole exercise tomorrow. Onward, we'll start the next concept. Thank you.